Hello everyone, this is BSc second year class of group theory. So today we are going to discuss equivalence classes or equivalence sets. Yesterday we have discussed what is mean by equivalence relation. A relation which is symmetric, reflexive and transitive, it is called as equivalence relation. Now today we are going to discuss equivalence classes or equivalence set. So write down the definition. Let A be a non-empty set. Let A be a non-empty set and let R be an equivalence relation in A, and let R be an equivalence relation on set A. Further, let A be an arbitrary element of A. A belongs to A, be any element. Small a belongs to capital A, be any element. The elements X belongs to A satisfying X is related to A constitutes a subset AA. That is, all X belongs to A which goes to the subset of A called as capital A suffix small a, which are related to A. म्हणजेच काय, असे A मधले सगळे एलिमेंट जे स्मॉल a शी रिलेटेड आहेत ते कोणत्या सेटमध्ये जाणार? इक्विवलेंस क्लास ऑफ A च्या सेटमध्ये जाणार. कॉल्ड A equivalence class of A with respect to relation R, of A with respect to relation R. Now equivalence class of small element small A belongs to capital A is denoted as AA, or equivalence class of A, or A bar is equal to X such that X belongs to A and X comma A is a member of relation R. That is, X is related to A. Now, equivalence class of A contains all elements which are related to A with respect to the relation R. So, for example, first, let A be a set of all triangles in a plane and let R be an equivalence relation in A defined by X is congruent to Y, so X is related to Y if X is congruent to Y. Now, this set contains all elements of X belongs to the set A such that X is congruent to Y. Now, example second. Let us determine the equivalence class in the set I of all integers with respect to the equivalence relation congruence modulo 5. X is congruent to 0 modulo 5, where X belongs to set of integers. Means those elements of integers which are divisible by 5 or which leave remainder 0 when divide it by 5. So equivalence class of this contains, so this can be I0 dot 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 plus minus 0 plus minus 5 plus minus 10 plus minus 15. So this is the equivalence class of this relation. Now properties of equivalence classes. Let A be a non-empty set and let R be an equivalence relation in A let small a and capital B, let A and B be arbitrary elements in A then first A belongs to class of A, second A belongs to class of A, second if B belongs to class of A, then class of B is equal to class of A. Now third, class of A is equal to class of B if and only if A comma B belongs to R, that is if and only if A is related to B. And fourth, either class of A is equal to class of B or class of A intersection class of B is empty. That is, two equivalence classes are either disjoint or identical. That is, two equivalence classes are either identical or disjoint. So this is the fourth point. Now understand one by one. Let A be a non-empty set and let R be an equivalence relation in A. A is the non-empty set and R is a equivalence relation in A. Let small a and capital B be arbitrary elements in A. If A comma B are the elements in A, then A belongs to class of A.
क्लास ऑफ ए मीन्स वॉट सेट ऑफ ऑल एलिमेंट्स इन ए विच आर रिलेटेड टू ए एंड वी नो दैट आर इज अ इक्विवेलेंस रिलेशन ऑन ए देयरफॉर इट इज अ रिफ्लेक्सिव एंड एवरी एलिमेंट इज रिलेटेड टू इटसेल्फ देयरफॉर ए बिलोंग्स टू कैपिटल ए. नाउ बी बिलोंग्स टू इक्विवेलेंस क्लास ऑफ ए देन इक्विवेलेंस क्लास ऑफ बी इज इक्वल टू इक्विवेलेंस क्लास ऑफ ए. नाउ बी बिलोंग्स टू इक्विवेलेंस क्लास ऑफ ए विच मीन्स दैट बी इज रिलेटेड टू ए एंड वी नो दैट इट इज सिमेट्रिक. सो इफ बी इज रिलेटेड टू ए देन ए इज रिलेटेड टू बी. दिस इंप्लाइज दैट क्लास ऑफ ए इज इक्वल टू क्लास ऑफ बी. नाउ इफ क्लास ऑफ ए इज इक्वल टू क्लास ऑफ बी इफ एंड ओनली इफ ए बी बिलोंग्स टू आर दैट इज ए इज रिलेटेड टू बी. नाउ इफ ए इज रिलेटेड टू बी then what we say that it is class it denotes that class of A is equal to class of B. therefore if A is related to B then the classes of both A and B are same. now fourth point, it is very important. Two classes are either identical or disjoint, and this does not happen like only two elements are common between them and only three elements and only one element is common between them. So they must be identical or disjoint and no other option. So two equivalence classes are either identical or disjoint. So today's lecture I am going to stop over here. Thank you.